Welcome to the Youth Shrine Bowl of the Carolinas, where youth football has its own standard. I'm Alan Hooker, and this is the 2019 edition of the sixth grade team coming from the best of North Carolina, which will be in the green called the Tar Heels, and the best sixth graders of South Carolina in the red called the Sandlappers. Ladies and gentlemen, these coaches have put together the best athletes that they could possibly find. Now, the trick to an all-star game is to being able to establish some kind of system based on the talent that you have. And by watching these kids over the last few days, there is some talent out here, and the coaches are extremely excited. Here's what you're going to see in this particular contest. You're going to see a mixture of run and pass. Each team has about 3 to 4 quarterbacks that can also play other positions. So you may see them on defense. You also may see them at receiver. And you may see them interchange at quarterback, even in the particular drives of the play. Most of the teams are going to play a 3-4 defense. However, they have the skill set to go 4-4, or they can put 8 in the box, and they can blitz, and they can also play man because of the amount of talent that they have. It is a overcast day. We're anticipating rain all day long. The biggest battle is not necessarily going to be the opponent, but it's going to be the elements. Look for a very slippery game. I anticipate that ball being on the ground a lot. However, these kids are excited, and you're going to see some fantastic action. So stay tuned for the 2019 Youth Shrine Bowl.
Amarion Coleman. Number 11, Jamarion Jackson.
Which one? Which one is that?
Number 13, Aiden Harris. Number 14, Andrew Harris.
Yeah, Tim, we'll just start recording.
Number 17, Bryson Sweat. Number 19, Stone Fleming.
You hear me, JT? So have the last person go, you go get the center.
Also wearing 19, Isaiah Gibson.
Remember, they're going to be the coaches too.
Number 24, Ruben Landrum. Number 25, Tamarion Watson. Number 44, Jayandra Foster. Number 45, Anthony Christopher.
Hits it.
Number 77, Daquan Evans. Yeah!
Become. No, you follow him just a little bit.
Number four, Ezekiel Bell Boyd.
The center of the field. The guy's in the middle. Yeah. Yeah, you get the whole team. I'm going to follow the last guy.
Number six, Jacorion Howes.
Because I'm not sure what it is. Wait. Now, Walt, you see the coaches over there? Are you still in front of the coaches?
Number 19, Isaiah Gibson. Number 19, Stone Fleming. Number 19, Aiden Walker. Number 32, Joshua Amara. And number 32, Kobe Davis.
Okay. Let's see if they don't call coaches on. I'm following the guy back. Who you on, Walt?
The South Carolina Sand Rappers are coached by assistant coach Doug Rivers.
I'm gonna get my shot. JT, get your shot. Go to my shot, Walker. JT.
Cedric Jones. Also, assistant coach Kenny Freeman.
Oh.
Richard Bonneville.
I'm gonna just switch.
And head coach, Mr. Nick Kellum.
Okay. Where's Wendy? Tell Wendy,
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together.
Hey, we need
for your South Carolina.
Hold on. You're in charge.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the North Carolina Tar Heels.
All right. Go to me, Walt, so JT can get a shot.
Number four, Scott Robitzer.
All right.
Also wearing number four, Laramie Watson. Number six, Elijah Bryant. Also wearing number six, Devontae Cunningham.
This court right here? It's red, white, and yellow.
Okay.
It's one court here. This one.
Number seven, Layton McLean.
In the back seat, it's a long black bag. This should be a college.
Number nine, Eric Klein. Number 10, Conatente Oleye. Number 12, Tayshawn Penny. Number 13, Eric Wright. Number 37, Alfonso Smith. Correction, Alfonso Smith. number 41, Cooper Pazin. Number 56, Jabari Cumbie. Number 58, Caleb Johnson.
Look, it's right next to JT Shaw.
Number 69, Jalen Johnson. Number 70, Logan Williams. Number 77, Zachary Friedman. Number 81, Jacoby Hudson. And number 95, Dominic Danji.
We'll get a chance to speak to you.
Assistant coach for North Carolina, Ron Wright.
No, let's wait till you do the national anthem. We'll get the challenge here. Okay, well?
Also assistant coach, Mr. Tony Gill.
Wait a minute, who you on? I'm not going to pay him while you eat ball. I said, who you on? You said, I'm on.
Assistant coach, Anthony Creasy. And the head coach of the North Carolina Tar Heels, Anthony Barber. Let's hear it for your North Carolina Tar Heels.
Okay.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we honor America for the singing of God Bless America, followed by our national anthem.
I'm so losing.
He's informed today by this entire
sport. I don't know if he's a rush out of your time. Alright, keep trying to move on. Alright, walk this one. I'm checking my feet. Tell me if you hear a little bit out here.
God bless America, my Lord.
I'm talking about, is my camera still on?
Thank you.
North Carolina, are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a wonderful overcast day for the Youth Shrine Bowl of the Carolinas, the Battle of the Borders. Youth football is not done any other way than like here. I am Alan Hooker, and here with me is Mr. Chris Zealous, QB1, the Team My Triad, player for a player of the year. Chris, how you doing today?
Doing good, Mr. Hooker.
Chris, let's talk a little bit about what these teams have. You've had an opportunity all week to kind of watch this sixth grade team practice, and they're coming from all over the state. Yeah. What have you seen in the last 3 days?
A lot of hard work from these kids. I mean, both teams have amazing athletes. You know, as East State has amazing athletes. So, I mean, today's going to be a battle of who can execute in the bad weather, who makes more plays.
So, Chris, you've had an opportunity to play on a soggy field like this. When preparing, what are some of the things that the kids have to prepare for when playing on soggy field?
Just different things, wet balls. You know, your cuts might not be the same for the receivers and DBs when breaking on balls and things like that. So, for them, they just have to come out and get adjusted. The big thing is get adjusted. So, in the first half, that's probably what we see out loud. Coaches making adjustments, players making adjustments. And bad weather games like this, you got to take care of the ball. Turnovers are costly anytime, but especially in bad weather.
So, Chris, you had an opportunity also to play defensive back. The defensive backs here in this soggy field, and what are you anticipating? You anticipating a lot of run? You anticipating a lot of pass?
I'm going to anticipate a lot of run. This first team, a lot of practice. They have, both teams have great running backs, and they're deep at running backs, so I expect to see a lot of runs from both teams.
Okay, all right. So we have our captains out on the field right now, And for sixth grade in North Carolina, the starting quarterback is going to be Eric Klein. And Eric Klein is has a strong arm. He's a steady guy. He may not be the quickest guy on the team, but he does a good job in directing the traffic and getting things going. But there's a number 37 that plays for North Carolina. Tell us a little bit about this gentleman, Chris.
Mr. Smith. He's about 6'1", and he can go. I mean, he can do it all: running back, receiver, outside receiver, slot receiver, and a lot. In practice, they worked on getting the ball in a lot of different ways. So I'll say they have a big game today.
So they had an opportunity this past week to kind of test each other out. So they had a mock game on yesterday. And it has been tradition that whoever wins the mock game normally does not fare as well in the actual game. So mock game yesterday went to the edge of North Carolina.
Yeah.
So based on history and prediction, South Carolina may have the better day, Chris. So what did we see in South Carolina yesterday?
Well, South Carolina, you know, just got to clean up the little mistakes, you know, fumbles, guys missing assignments. So, I mean, for South Carolina, they clean up the mistakes, they can have a big day today.
All right, so this is the long-awaited time of what these kids have been waiting for all year long. They have been talking about the selections was made earlier in the summer. They knew they were coming here. They had to go through their regular season, and now they're at the point of what they dreamed about, playing in the All-Star game here in beautiful, serene stadium in Greenville, South Carolina. The field is immaculately painted. I don't know if we can get a shot of that logo, but James Riley and Victorious Vision out of Greensboro, North Carolina, came here and put his arts and craft right on the field, and it's a good showing. It's a good-looking logo.
Okay, so right here we have Cooper Padgett kicking off for the North Carolina team. He's also the center, very versatile guy, so let's see what he has here.
All right, so sometimes you have little miscues, Chris, when you've only been practicing for 3 days. You don't get an opportunity to do the special teams.
Yeah.
So here we go. Our officials are going to reset. All right, so we have a short kick. Ball is recovered by Andrew Harris, number 14. So South Carolina will begin at their own 41.5. So South Carolina comes out in shotgun formation. You got slot motion. Strong right side barking out the signals.
Kind of right.
And that quarterback keeps it, and he runs up to North Carolina's 46-yard line, Chris.
Yeah. I mean, South Carolina's got a versatile quarterback. He can throw it a little bit, and he can run it as well. So we're going to have to see how North Carolina handles the misdirection out of this.
Great misdirection. They had the defense flowing over to the right side. So now South Carolina comes back out first and 10.
South Carolina in the gun again. We get a handoff here, right side. Olele right there on the tackle. Olele should have a big day today. I mean, nobody can handle him in practice. He's taking on double teams easily, so I expect him to have a big day.
And that's Reuben Landrum on the carry. Picks up 1 yard. quarterback. He dives off left. He shakes the tackle and gets a good surge in there, Chris. He's a hard runner. They're going to, I guarantee you. It's down to the North Carolina 42-yard line. It's going to be third and about five.
Might see a pass right here. Every play so far has been a run. Might see North Carolina defense starting to get aggressive.
Strong right. And it's the hand, it's a give, and he bounces to the left. This is Landrum. This is what he's known for. Yes. He hits the speed. And that is Landrum on the carry, number 24.
Great vision right there. Saw the cutback left side. Hit it fast.
He's a running back slash linebacker from Moore, South Carolina. And they have the spiffiest helmets out here. If I had to give a helmet award, I'm giving it to the kids with the Gators.
Yeah.
Not necessarily the most original, but they do duplication better than any other
anybody.
Team out here. First and 10 for the Sandlappers.
Quarterback in there.
And we have a delay of game.
Now I have Jamari Wilson in at quarterback. Tamarion Watkins lined up to the right of him.
Jamari Wilson is from Dillon, South Carolina. Plays multiple positions.
Good to see a halfback pass right here. Good tackle by Smith.
Good tackle by Smith. Temion Watkins on the carry. Loss of one. Smith did a great job coming up that time.
Coming from the weak side.
Actually, Jordan Strong is actually a quarterback. And that's Jordan on the run with a good speed, spin. And look at Jordan run. Keep his legs driving down to the 8-yard line. Jordan Strong from Richburg, South Carolina. Pickup of about 13.
I mean, this is what you want to do in the bad weather. You want to be able to run the ball early.
Down to the 8-yard line. And there's Smith again. There's that man. That ball was carried by Watkins, number 25. Pickup of no gain.
Going strong, just the pass. Flips out of the screen right side and is. Incomplete, almost picked off by number 12, North Carolina.
You're watching the Youth Shrine Bowl on TEN Web TV.
Tayshawn Bennett with the pass breakup.
It brings up a third down.
Strong pitches to the right. And listen, Watkins, who was the quarterback earlier, turns and throws the ball and looks that the whistle has not blown. And it is a fumble. The officials are gathering. It appears that it was
like
a flea flicker.
Pass, yeah.
Right, like a halfback pass. Watkins threw the ball. They gave him the reception, and then they ruled that he fumbled the ball. So it will be North Carolina's ball on the 4-yard line.
Big stop for North Carolina's defense down their own territory. Two big stops on pass plays by North Carolina's 6th grade team. Quarterback for the North Carolina team, Haynes Robeser. That's L.J. Watts in the backfield with him. Timeout by North Carolina team.
Timeout by North Carolina. And so we are here after South Carolina drives the ball all the way down inside the red zone, turns the ball over. We'll be right back with more Youth Shrine Football Battle of the Carolinas. So Watson is the ball carrier. Minus two. So a second down. On the 3.5-yard line, Klein.
It's actually Robeson, right?
Quarterback. Robeson, the quarterback.
Watson to the left of him. The spread look. Robeson drops the pass. Intended for Smith right there.
Pass is incomplete. Intended for his big target. And I'll tell you now, if that ball is on the money, Smith has room. And smart call by Coach. He's not being conservative at all.
Yeah, Smith can go. I mean, that practice took him about 60 yards.
Absolutely. He's a horse, and you will see him at various positions.
Roster spread out again. L.J. Watson in the backfield. Bring Benny into motion.
Good carry, dive up the middle, pick up at about 8, at the 8-yard line, pick up of about 6. And so it's going to be.
So North Carolina is going to elect a punt.
So an all-star rule, with walk off the punt. And so it will be South Carolina's ball. On North Carolina's 33-yard line.
Kicks it right side. Another tackle.
I tell you, Smith is going to be in a lot of places today. We can anticipate him not only on offense, but he's going to be one of the major contributors. But he is a leading tackler right now from North Carolina in the game. And if not for, and that's a pickup of 7 yards. So they're now on the 31. I'm sorry. Now on the 26 of North Carolina. Another dive. Ruben Layton for South Carolina. He's been the workhorse so far. Every time he's touched the ball, he's had positive yards.
South Carolina looks like they're kind of toe line scrimmage early in this game. They've been able to do a good job of it. Right there.
Quarterback sweep to the left, and it takes an army of North Carolina to bring down Rocket. Walking from Rock Hill, South Carolina, playing a dual role today. We've seen him a lot at quarterback, running back, and we may see that halfback pass again, Chris, if this ain't get crunchy. Yeah.
I think so.
So South Carolina coming back out in the spread. North Carolina is running a 3-4 defense. Misdirection with Big Rock in the Walking, the ball is down on the 15.
Zachary Freeman on the tackle.
Zachary Freeman was on the tackle, also accompanied by Mr. Smith. So it is third down and short for the South Carolina 6th grade sand lappers. And Walker's off to the right side, and he slips down. Good game-saving tackle that time by number 12 from North Carolina. And that's Jason Bennett. And if you notice on the North Carolina sideline, well, on both sidelines, you don't see a whole lot of players on the sideline. So a lot of kids are going to be going both ways, getting opportunities to split their skills. Walking the signal caller. Hands it off to Ruben. So Chris, tell me why that play is effective.
Well, we have the running back. We have the running back in the misdirection. The defense knows they have the key on them. That allows a quarterback to be able to run wherever he wants to, really. But now they have both guys running hard. The defense has to figure out which one they want to stop, and it's almost a pick and pull. Smith with another tackle.
Alfonso Smith leading the charge. In for the third time.
So we come out of the timeout on the field. South Carolina is moving the ball at will, but North Carolina is bending, but they've yet to give up a score. They will not break. And so it is third down and about 3 yards to go. And so we'll take a break right here for some of our sponsors. We'll be right back with more football here in Greenville, South Carolina. I'm Alan Hooker with Chris Dellis. Stay tuned. However, based on what we've seen today, it's holding true that the team that wins the scrimmage doesn't necessarily become the stronger team during the game. However, there's a lot of football to play here, and North Carolina has some tricks up their sleeve.
Yeah, we'll see what they can do. They feel good. You know, first time they ball, they're on the home field. I think they have a better chance of better field position.
Kicking off for South Carolina is Thornton Fleming. And under the conditions, good swim kick, and it goes to Smith. He dips to the left. Can't get away from the strong arms of South Carolina tackle. And so North Carolina will take over on their own 43.
Well, after the kickoff, the Tar Heels have a first and 10 ball on their own 43.
This must be an exciting time, not just for the players, but also for the parents. And knowing your mom very well, what would she be doing if you were 11 years old out here playing an All-Star game?
She had a cowbell, and everybody that came with her would have a
cowbell. All right, so here we go, North Carolina. Fakes a dome read, and there's Smith. He breaks two passes, three tackles for a gain of 10 yards. So he goes from the 43 to the other 43. And there is a flag on the field.
What a great representative right there. I mean, he has two South Carolina guys right in his face when he gets the ball and makes them both miss.
So there's a sideline warning against South Carolina. First down. North Carolina.
Tar Heel, first down.
All right, here we go. South Carolina, Chris, appears to be in a 3-4 defense.
Well, Smith, the running back now, he's lined up a five, split right to Roberson.
And that's Smith up the middle, just tipped up, and that's a touchdown saving tackle.
Great misdirection, and they're trapping that up. No tackle. Smith having a great game.
That tackle was saved by Jamari Jackson from Houston, South Carolina, from the free safety spot, came up and laid the hit on Smith. And there's a blitz by South Carolina, and they snip out the jet sweep.
Deshaun Bennett, the ball carrier.
Deshaun Bennett.
In his backfield, at number 13, Aiden Harris.
Aiden Harris on the tackle.
North Carolina.
Lost
44.
Back to the 44.
Third down. First to the South Carolina 44. Third down.
Might see a deep ball right here by North Carolina. All week they've been practicing a lot. They've been very successful in practice this week. Throw for the gun. Smith lined up to the right over.
Smith off to the left side. Pick up of about two. It will be third down.
Alfonso Smith, the ball carrier.
Fourth down. Fourth down and five.
Is down
fourth
two.
Down territory for North Carolina.
Go for it right here.
South Carolina 42. Brings up a fourth and five.
Rain is starting to come down even harder now. It's making that ball a little more slippier. And there's a break of a tackle by Smith. And he is throwing off defenders. He is fighting with all he has. And he gets down to the South Carolina 40.
Stop short of the first down. Make some noise for your South Carolina It'll be first and 10, South Carolina, ball on their own 40.
Well, Chris, that was some good action right there. I mean, North Carolina had a pretty good drive going. They picked up a couple of first downs. The big play of that drive was the tackle made by Harris on the blitz coming up on that zone, on that jet sweep. So South Carolina comes back out with Watkins at the quarterback position. And he gets a block on the corner. Good strong run that time, but looks like there's a flag on the play, Chris. It's going to be coming back.
Safety back there, Dan made a great tackle.
Number 14, the ball carrier, penalty marker on the field. Preliminary indication, illegal block against South Carolina. That was Andrew Harris on the carry. So after the penalty, it'll be first and 10. Harrison first and 20. Ball now in the South Carolina 30-yard line.
And as Watkins, he's bumping now. He has some room. He's stretching those long legs out, putting the move on the corner.
That play's been very effective for South Carolina all day. Sweep, power left, the lead. We're
going to running back to the ball carrier.
Great play for him all day.
Forced out of bounds by Zayshon Bennett. But not before. He crosses midfield. Get it up for another. South Carolina.
Backside.
First down.
Watkins back in the shotgun.
Andrew Harris.
Andrew Harris is a tough runner.
Takes it across the 40 down in the 39-yard line.
Pick up of about 8 yards.
On the tackle. It'll be second and short, South Carolina.
So you got Watkins, Harris, still back, and it's direct snap to Watkins, and he moves the ball from the 39
Watkins on the carry
to the 31-yard line.
Watkins doing a great job of finding the block right there, picking the right hole in the first down.
Gain is up across the 35, down to the 34.
Down to the 34-yard line.
South Carolina, first down.
And it's just been a basic recipe of quarterback, halfback runs here for South Carolina. And that's
great tackle right there for a loss by L.J. Watson. That's a running back.
Andrew Harris, the ball carrier.
Great tackle loss right there.
He stopped in his backfield by Laramie Watson.
Back into the game is number 24, Reuben Landrum at the halfback position. And Landrum gets it off tackle, and he bends it back to the left side. He's at the 10, 5, and pushed out of bounds by Smith at the 2, at the 3-yard line.
What a cutback by Landrum. I mean, everybody's going right. He was trying to find a hole right. He saw in the backside, pushed in the ground, got up big fast.
That was Reuben Landrum on the carry. It'll be first and goal, South Carolina, ball on the North Carolina 3-yard line.
All right, we have
timeout,
substitution.
North Carolina.
Timeout, North Carolina.
That's their second charge timeout of the half.
So the score right now is 6-0 with South Carolina knocking on the door with 3 minutes and 29 seconds remaining in the half. Chris, if you're the North Carolina coach, what are you saying to your players?
I mean, for this y'all right here, it's got to be another bend, don't break. I mean, they've been in this situation before, so for the coaches, just letting them know, you know, hey, we've been in this situation already, and we just have to make another play again and get stops.
And so now with South Carolina knocking on the door on the 3-yard line, wanting to take advantage of this opportunity, what do you think Coach Pelham is saying to his kids right now?
Probably just keep doing what they've been doing all game. They control the line of scrimmage, getting great push up the line. So right there, I think Watson's going to make another play for a touchdown.
And so, and we have cheerleaders here. Even out here in the rain, they're dedicated to cheering on their sand lappers. And we see them right here. They have their ponchos on and the pom-poms. We're so thankful for everyone who has participated in this entire week in celebrating kids, as we also bring awareness for the Shriners Hospital.
Let's go, offense. Punch it in there.
Looks like they're running to the tight end side a lot.
Well, let's see. You got Landrum in there. You got Watkins. And now we have shifted movement.
Right to the side.
And it's the quarterback three to the left side. And it is a touchdown. Tavarian Watkins, he's been a real influential player for this drive for South Carolina out of Rock Hill.
Number 25 on the carry.
Chris, what made that play effective?
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. The concession stand is now open for your refreshing needs as well as you shine bold apparel.
To do a better job of adjusting it. They're getting an extra blocker, which is allowing Watkins to spring loose.
Go get yours right now.
Shotgun formation. Landrum's in the backfield, along with Watkins, the signal caller.
And
he did it like he was going to pass. He sprints, goes out. And he had a man.
Two-point conversion is no good. 3 minutes, 22 seconds left to go in the first half. South Carolina 12, North Carolina.
He had Jackson over in the corner, wide open. Had he been able to get away and throw that ball, it could have been a touchdown. We'll be right back. We're going to run the break into 12-0. South Carolina and North Carolina, 3:22 remaining. We'll be right back. We're back, and Fleming with the kickoff. It's a short kick. Ball is still in Bennett. He's going out wide, and he's showing off his nifty move, but he is hit hard. By number 13.
Deshaun Bennett on the carry, on the return.
Aiden Harris. On the top.
He is welcome to the ground by number 13, Aiden Harris. It'll be first and 10, North Carolina ball. The South Carolina 46-yard line.
North Carolina's ball on the 46-yard line of South Carolina. They're going to try to see if they get something rolling with 3 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the half.
See if they can build on that good yard they had last time. New quarterback in there, flying in now with Smith lined up right over the gun.
Get in there, defense! Get that quarterback sandwich! Hit him! Hit him, defense! Get in there, hit him!
Looked like there was a miscommunication. Klein looked as if he was going to hand the ball off to Smith. Doesn't quite. Smith leads him up into the hole. He doesn't quite get there. He continues to roll out to the outside. And so there's no gain.
He's tackled by number 19. Short gain on the play, second down. Correction, tackle made by number 6. Recording house. Second down.
So here we are. What we saw yesterday from North Carolina is a little misdirection. Of course, we had dry balls yesterday, so they threw the ball a little more.
Yeah.
But North Carolina may have to start considering throwing a little more, and I wouldn't be surprised if they go some wildcat with Smith some.
Yeah, I mean, Smith can do it all.
They might have a pass.
So delay of game. Assessed to North Carolina, 5-yard penalty. So after the delay of game penalty, North Carolina comes back. It is now 2nd and 15. Klein still the signal caller. Two receivers in the slot. We've got slot motion by Bennett. And the ball is given to Smith off to the left side. And he is tackled by a host of stand lappers.
That's on to Smith on the carry. And he's tackled by half of the South Carolina defense. Losses back near midfield, brings up a third down.
So they mark it back at the 50. He still makes it third down at about 14, at about 14 yards. So that's a pickup of one based on the spot. Gives to Smith, and he has room. He breaks the tackle, and he will go all the way. 50-yard touchdown.
Mr. Smith makes reservations for
this,
six.
This is a little bit
and North Carolina
about
is on the board.
Talk to us about how this play developed.
Where he has singles on left. I think Smith saw a cutback in the hole. Backside, great vision by him. Stuck his foot in the ground and got up field extremely fast.
Extremely fast because that's what North Carolina is going to constantly do. And Smith is one of those kind of workhorses where if you keep giving it to him, he works like in the movie. Remember the Titans when Coach Herman Boone said the beard is a lot like Novocaine. Just keep giving it to him, give it time, and it'll start working.
Right there, what you got is telling him you just want to get three carries, and it just ain't pop himself.
Well, here we go. Now, this could make a difference in the game. We talked about leaving windows open. South Carolina left the window open a couple of times for North Carolina. And so there is a timeout with North Carolina. There's 6 seconds
North
remaining.
Carolina. That's their final timeout.
So we're going to go into a quick commercial break. We'll be right back. From Greenville, South Carolina, you sign both.
Position later in the game. North Carolina can get this two-point conversion, that will put them in a very good position going on later into the game, as South Carolina is not executing on both of theirs. So another touchdown by North Carolina after this two-point conversion can give them a chance for the lead.
Puts them in there for the lead. You're exactly right, Chris. So that is exactly what coach is thinking about right now, where that timeout was perfect for him to call. 6 seconds to go in the half. You got Klein at the quarterback position. Smith is flanked out left as the number one receiver, trips right. And they go isolate back side to Smith. And it's a touch. And it's good. Conversion is good. Klein with a two-point conversion.
Great throw by Klein, giving his big receiver a chance to go up and get the ball. And that's exactly what Smith does.
Penalty marker on the field.
So let's see what this penalty marker is all about on the field. Illegal procedure by North Carolina. We play the try.
We'll retry. Yes, we want.
Excellent play call that time, and coach has seen something just by working with these kids a couple of days, and to identify what their strengths are is a testament to Anthony Barber, who is a native of Garner, North Carolina, graduated from Garner High School in 88 and was a running back, and led his team to the state football championship in 1987, and he was named North Carolina's Player of the Year. He went on to have a very successful career at NC State, graduating in 92 with a degree of sociology.
It's nice to see Smith line up coming out here on the right side. There's a size advantage out there.
So it looks like Smith is triple team. You've got Tripp's left side, and you've got Smith triple team on the right side, and Klein still throws it up to Smith, and it is good for the conversion try.
Smith is a player. Klein is doing a great job giving him a chance to go up and get the ball. From the quarterback, you want to put the ball where only your receiver can do it and get in. That's what Klein is doing.
That's what Klein is doing. He's throwing a nice ball, even in the inclement weather. But quarterbacks can't make excuses for wet balls, right?
You can't make excuses for cold balls.
The ball is designed to be thrown. You better throw it. An excellent job by Klein and great hands. And he was triple teamed.
Big momentum swing from North Carolina right here going into halftime.
Teams are coming out.
Ladies and gentlemen, rain ponchos are on sale at the concession stand. Ponchos, barbecue, and hash is open and ready for business.
North Carolina right now has 18 rushes for 42 yards. They're 1-for-2 in passing with a two-point conversion and one fumble loss and a couple of penalties. While South Carolina has 5 first downs, they're at 8 rushing attempts for 60 yards. There's an onside kick attempt. Great job that time by South Carolina's number 32.
They will have a first and 10.
Kobe Davis. Out of Rock Hill, South Carolina.
Let's see how South Carolina plays it right here. I mean, it's 5 seconds left. Great field position. Might take a shot right here.
And so right here, we'll take a look at some of the team leaders. Thus far, we have Mr. Smith, 6 rushes for 99 yards. He has 1 reception for a 2-point conversion. He also has multiple tackles. South Carolina leading rusher is Watkins with 4 carries and 47 yards, followed by Landrum with 31 yards rushing.
both teams are doing a great job of finding the social page in the game to execute them.
Shout out to the back judge, Michael Jackson, moonwalking back to the 15-yard line.
Starting from 49-yard line, they give the ball to Landrum. He plunges forward all the way down to the 37-yard line of North Carolina.
That will end the first half of today's first game without a score.
That'll do it for the half. 12-8, South Carolina edge, but North Carolina has the momentum as we roll into halftime. Stay tuned and we'll be back with more highlights and halftime stats. And that is Bennett. Bennett turns back and carries the ball. Great run for North Carolina over into South Carolina's 47-yard line. Chris, you are real high on this Bennett kid. You've had an opportunity to watch him for a couple of days. Tell the fans about what you saw on this guy.
I mean, the speedster, he has good hands. And I think right now it's getting to the point in the game where Smith is starting to get keyed on by the South Carolina defense. So I think they can use that misdirection to get Smith, get Bennett on the outside and let him use his exceptional speed.
So North Carolina comes back out. When they left the first half, they had momentum. They had all the momentum.
They got Roberson back in at quarterback. And Laramie Watson lined up to the right of him.
Tipped out to the left. With Smith, and there's a give up the middle, and that's a great defensive play.
Laramie Watson on the carry. Short hand of the play. Daquan Evans on the tackle.
Evans on that tackle, number 77.
Second down.
And Evans did a good job. He's been playing nose tackle, but they moved him around a little bit from nose, and then sometimes he'll play in a five technique. But Evans is out of Fort Lawn, South Carolina. Referee calls an incomplete pass, and that pass was almost picked off. I tell you what, if number 14, Harris, times that ball up, Chris, we got a different ball game
pick
here.
Six right there.
It's a big six. So it's a third down.
It'll be third and long for North Carolina.
Robeson and Watson lined up in the backfield.
And so the ball is given. Almost comes down. Pick up. 14.
Watson's running hard. One game or two right there. Tough setting right now for North Carolina offense. They like to punt it right here.
The voluntary punt rule gives the punting team a 25-yard kick.
Punt rule. Give them a 25-yard kick. It's going to move the ball to South Carolina's 20-yard line. It's going to be on the South Carolina's 18.
Watkins and company for South Carolina to come back out.
Watkins at the quarterback spot, calling the signals, hands the ball off to Landrum. He is hit hard at the line of scrimmage by a host of North Carolina tacklers.
We got a flag right here, though. And you might have a face mask right here.
Landrum looks like he is banged up just a little bit.
personal foul face mask penalty against North Carolina.
It's a face mask penalty against North Carolina. Looking at Landrum, he's feeling his face, and probably one of the kids inadvertently stuck their hand into his face mask.
Here we go, Watkins back in the gun. Handoff right side of 14. Tackled by a host of Carolina players right there.
Andrew Harris, the ball carrier. So lost on the play, middle number 95, Dominic Dansby on the tackle.
Strong game for quarterback. Strong run by Strong right there. We got a penalty flag though. Have a flag on the play. Right there we have a power right. South Carolina's been doing that all day using the lead blocker.
The coaches award will be given after this game. The player awards will be given immediately following the eighth grade game.
Flag's been picked up. There will be no penalty on the play. Sideline warning for North Carolina. Sweep left by Strong. Spins off the tackler. He'll be close to the first down, but I don't think he'll have enough.
George Strong on the carry. Takes it up near.
And the power left with the lead blocker of the running back.
Brings up a fourth and one.
Fourth and short right here. South Carolina's going to go for it. Lock in, back in that quarterback.
I can anticipate, based off of the strategies that they've used earlier, that it's that Watkins, who's a strong runner, may keep it. And that time, doesn't mix up in the backfield.
Mishandled snap right there.
And North Carolina will take it over on down.
He has stopped short of the first.
Maybe the inclement weather is coming in to play a part right there with that mishandled snap.
North Carolina will take over first and 10. Make some noise here, North Carolina.
And North Carolina gets the stop that they needed.
First and 10, Tar Heels, ball in the South Carolina 48.
Let's see what Roberson and this North Carolina offense can put together right here on this drive. Smith lined up in the slot, Watson in the backfield. Been in motion. Watson is swallowed by a host of South Carolina defenders right there. Caden Walker right
he
there on the stop.
Tavarion Watkins leading the charge. Second down.
Smith move back to the backfield. Motion coming from the right side.
North Carolina has their big guy in the backfield. They give it to him, and South Carolina snuffs it out. Tremendous pressure coming from the A and B gap of North Carolina, and they back it back to the 45-yard line.
North Carolina.
And so now, Chris, we come up with third and a long 16.
Fans, just a reminder, this game could be a good beat for sale. Stay up in the press box.
What we know about North Carolina is that they got a couple of kids with great speed. I don't know if you got Bennett and then you got the Swiss Army.
Man, I wouldn't be surprised if we see a trick play right here.
Timeout, North Carolina. The first charge timeout of the half.
We might see a trick play right here by North Carolina. I mean, third quarter, 3:22 left, need a big play right here.
We are back at beautiful South Carolina. This is a immaculate field to be at the end of December. Look at all the greenage that's out here. And I know they do a good job in Greensboro, North Carolina, Grimsby High School. But, Chris, I'm impressed with the amount of green that's here.
Great field. All right, we move Smith back to quarterback. First time he's been back there.
All right, so here we are. It looks like it's crunch time. It's third down, and you know what's coming. It is Smith, and he makes a move right on the outside. He runs over a couple of players, but the flag's in the backfield. It looks like it's going to be a holding.
Now bring it back again.
Against North Carolina.
That penalty will be declined.
So the penalty will be declined.
Brings up a fourth down.
Brings up fourth down. The ball is now going to be marked at about the 50. It looks like it's a pickup of about 5. And so North Carolina, first with the 25-yard kick rule. So South Carolina will take over with 3 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the third quarter. It is 8-12. The Sandlappers still in control.
Very important job right here for both teams. Sandlappers looking to take control of the game, and North Carolina looking to get back in the lead. Walker is coming back out from South Carolina. Landrum in the backfield, split left to him. Watkins.
It's a nifty move, and he goes down the alley. Right,
he might be gone.
Line, but he is going to be hawked down.
Got a flag, though. We've got a flag. Got a flag. He's coming back. Got holding right there. Great effort.
That holding call negates almost a 60-yard run. For South Carolina. But what I want to point out is
back
that particular play.
First and all, South Carolina, ball in row 13.
Is
Jabari Cumby, who played O-line and D-line, ran down the running back.
Great effort, about 30 yards right there.
So we're here replaying first down.
Ooh.
And the game is the Landry, he runs into one of his own players, and they're still having a difficult time bringing Landry down. And that tackle that time was Babatunde Olele.
He blew that up.
Yeah. And Babatunde Olele actually won a couple of awards last night.
Yes, he did.
One of the academic awards is going to him. A great young man had an opportunity to meet with his mom.
He's had a great week of practice. I mean, he's been working hard all week and it's showing here.
He's a trainer on the field, South Carolina.
And he is from Gastonia, North Carolina. A lot of good athletes come out of Gastonia. And so there's an injury on the field. All right, so while we have a break in action on the field, we're going to pause here for a quick break, and we'll be right back with more action from the Youth Shrine Bowl of the Carolinas, the standard for youth football. All right, so we're back. Thanks for sticking with us through that brief break. South Carolina has the ball, second down on their own 13.
Motion by the tight end with the run to his side.
And the ball is given to Landerman. He has some room on the outside. And if he can turn the corner, to be down to the 20, 25.
Great tackle by the safety, Danny, right there. Safe
touchdown. He stepped out of bounds quick on the 27-yard line. Good play. And you know what made that play effective were the big offensive linemen. They pulled the guard, and he was able to get scraped and just get something on the defensive end. And then allowed him to get out around the outside.
And again, South Carolina running to that tight end side, bringing the motion to cause a little bit of confusion with the North Carolina defense.
You know, earlier we talked about big number 77 for South Carolina. Daquan Evans from Fort Lawn, South Carolina. He made that play happen.
He can move. Anytime a big guy can get up on the second level of the linebacker, that's always great for the running back. Makes their job a lot easier.
So here we are. Tight end moving over to the right side of the line.
Might be misdirection right here.
Delay of game penalty against South Carolina. 5-yard penalty against third down.
Delay of game for South Carolina. 5-yard penalty. Tight knit ball game, and it's tough in all star games to be able to grab guys and. You know, I see Coach over there, Coach Pelham. He's coached for 22 years, and he's putting together his strategy here for these young all-stars. And there's Watkins. He's off to the side.
He might have enough. He's got enough.
And he has enough for the first down. Watkins, that ball is going to be placed.
Samarion Watkins on the carry.
Great job by Landry right there to pick up.
To
pick up the incoming defensive lineman right there. I mean, Landry doesn't make that block. Watkins doesn't get free for the first down.
Exactly right. Another first down for the South Carolina Sand Lappers. And there's a minute and 26 seconds remaining in the third quarter. And so we're having a conversation now with Smith over on the sideline. Don't know if they're checking some equipment. Looks like they're looking at his hand. And if he can't return, that's a big hit because he's the majority of North Carolina's offense.
Yeah. That's right there.
No, back in the backfield.
Kalen Johnson right there.
Kalen with the big play. I tell you what, between Kalen and Babatunde there on that defensive line, they're starting to get some surge.
Yeah, I think they're starting to find their footing right now. That's two big tackle for losses right here.
So now in the backfield, you have Watkins and you have the big running
power right. Great open field tackle by Bennett right there.
Bennett doing a good job shedding the block, getting his hands up and getting off the man. Able to come in and secure the tackle.
Maybe a touchdown saving tackle right there.
That's right. Watkins is picking up speed. He's the kind of running back where he gets a little better. The more yards he gets, his long leg down. And so here we go. The third quarter comes to an end. Fourth quarter with South Carolina. Third down and about eight. As they go into the fourth quarter, ladies and gentlemen.
Like I said, this is a big drive right here for both teams. As North Carolina's trying to get back in the lead, and South Carolina's looking to close out this game.
Stay tuned, and we'll be right back with more football from the New Shrine Bowl. Greenville, South Carolina. Hello, welcome back to the Youth Shrine Bowl of the Carolinas, the standard for youth football. I'm Alan Cooper alongside Chris Dellis, and this is the first game of the day, the sixth grade from North Carolina versus the sixth grade from South Carolina. The score is 8-12, with the Sandlappers leading by four, and they're also driving to convert on this particular drive. It is third down and a long eight. South Carolina, Chris, has been able to move the ball primarily through the quarterback, and maybe by design, they haven't been holding the ball a whole lot, probably because of inclement weather.
Yeah, I mean, they haven't needed to win the ball. They control the line scrimmage, doing a great job. Their linemen are doing a great job of getting on guys again to the second level. That's bringing their running backs free.
Down here on defense, you've got Bennett down here at the corner, and Bennett blitzes, and Jordan breaks away. One tackle.
Great job by Strong to get positive yards right there.
Jordan Strong makes it out to the 42.
Brings up a fourth down. Decision time for South Carolina.
So now it's fourth and six. Early on in the fourth quarter, 9 minutes and 23 seconds, Coach Pelham may gallop a gamble here. Coach Pelham coached his first 10 years in Michigan in that high school system, and moved to South Carolina and been at Dutch Fork and Richland Northeast and in Westwood High School. At Westwood, he helped lead the 2014 defense and allowed the fewest total points in 4A classification. And instead, he changes his mind and goes to the automatic punt.
After the punt of the first and 10, Tar Heels ball on their own 33.
Right here, North Carolina has a chance to take lead. Smith seems to be okay as he's checking back into the game.
North Carolina will take over on their own 33-yard line.
Line back in, that quarterback has Smith lined up to the right of him.
Then it goes in motion. The ball is given to Smith. And there's no gain.
Alfonso Smith on the carry. He's been in backfield by number 19, Caden Walker.
A good tackle that time by Walker.
Coming from the backside right there.
Caden is also from Rock Hill, South Carolina. Several names that we called out today from kids from Rock Hill. He's doing a fantastic job here today. South Carolina has changed their defensive front. Starting to walk the linebacker down.
Klein back in at quarterback.
Blitz off the end. That time the defensive man outside linebacker applied tremendous pressure, which allowed that man to get Walker.
Walker.
Lawson's back inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Brings him a third and long.
I tell you, Isaiah Gibson from Gaffney, South Carolina, applied great pressure that time, which is what allowed allowed the sack on the previous play. Now here we go. The ball is picked up. Amarion Coleman from Marquette, South Carolina, linebacker.
And that was a one-handed interception right there. Great play.
Great play.
Great job by Coleman right there, being alert. You know, in games like this, the DBs can kind of fall asleep with all this running, but he didn't fall asleep. He was ready for the pass.
He was ready, and I don't know if the ball slipped out of Klein's hands. We've watched him throw some dimes today in this inclement weather. At that time, the ball came out of his hand a little wobbly, and I'm just curious if he had the proper grip on it, if it slipped out.
Weather could definitely play a part in that one right there.
You're exactly right.
Ladies and gentlemen, just a reminder, in the event of a tie ball game, the trophies will be donated to...
So 5 minutes and 42 seconds remaining.
North Carolina's still in this game, though. I mean, their defense has really been able to get some good stops right here in the second half of the game.
And we've got a timeout with 5 minutes and 40 seconds remaining. It is South Carolina 12, North Carolina 8. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Youth Shrine Bowl. Penalty on the play. Illegal motion by South Carolina. 5-yard penalty. That'll put the Sand Lappers back on the 31.
Walker's in the backfield with Landry lined up to the left of him. Wilson tight end. There's power left again.
Walker's going. He gets the block.
Landry.
On the outside on Cumbie. Walking down to the 20.
Landry's been doing a great job of finding somebody to get a hat on and find somewhere for Watkins to be able to go. I mean, Landry might not get every carry, but he's been a big part in every play in the run game.
And I tell you what, leading him around the corner, Daquan Evans, offensive guard.
Come on!
Langeline again for Watkins. With Evans and come. That would be enough for a first down for South Carolina.
Ball is going to be marked on the 15-yard line. Moving the chain.
Babatunde Olaeye on the tackle. Game is down to the 15.
Babatunde from Gastonia, South Carolina. Gastonia, North Carolina. Has been on several plays today. South Carolina comes out.
Watkins again.
And he is just weaving his way.
Watkins only carrying.
And I don't want to say casually, but he's almost just picking his spot.
Got a right touchdown here. Right there by Watkins again. I mean, Coach Tellum found something he likes to that left side, man. Three straight run plays to the left side. Landrum and Evans lead blocks for Watkins have been a great combination all day.
All day long, so South Carolina increases their lead. So it's 18-8. You see, we have a sparse crowd here, a little rain coming out, and we don't have the umbrella rule, so fans are able to bring their umbrellas, sit in the stands.
To the left side again, Watkins.
And he is wrapped up by Smith, and no, he breaks away from Smith, but is captured by three other tacklers from North Carolina.
Smith right there makes a great play to keep Watkins from getting to the outside.
South Carolina 18, North Carolina 8.
So the point after touchdown is no good.
Look for Smith and Bennett to be a big part of this job right here for North Carolina. They got to get the ball into the hands of their playmakers right here.
I think you're going to see some things especially dialed up. It is now and never for North Carolina. They've got to get on the board.
Yeah.
That's so close.
I think we're going to have a quarterback change right here on this drive. Haynes Robeser coming in.
We haven't seen Haynes Robeson throw the ball a lot today. He's primarily been handing it off. And I don't know if that was an onside attempt on purpose, but South Carolina's thinking that they have it, but the official indication is that North Carolina has recovered the ball at the 50.
I mean, Robeson hasn't thrown a lot here, but I mean, during the week in practice, I've seen him throw it around a lot in the routes on there, 7-on-7. I mean, he can get the ball out there pretty fast.
We have an injury on the field. So the youth sign bowl is in its third year. First 2 years were played. Well, last year was played in Charlotte, North Carolina. Then the game has been moved here to Greenville, South Carolina. And the people of Greenville have done a fantastic job of welcoming the Shrine Bowl committee here, and all proceeds going to benefit the Shriners Hospital located here in Greenville, South Carolina.
North Carolina looking to take over at the 50-yard line. Roaster in the quarterback with Smith in the backfield with him. Bennett line up in left slot.
So right now, Chris, as we are currently, North Carolina has only amassed three first downs.
Is it, bro? Oh.
Forward pass is incomplete to Smith, who slips down. He had a little room.
The intended receiver. Second down.
And I'll tell you one thing about Smith. Alfonso has 8 rushes for 100 yards. 1 pass reception. So he's been the majority of North Carolina's offense. I can anticipate him getting the ball. The other thing I'm going to look for is you can look for Bennett in these situations because everybody's eyes are going to be on Smith. Bennett, who is the beast on the outside, can give him a lot of advantages. As well, one individual I haven't seen them go through a whole lot, and that's Elijah Bryant. Be interesting to see if they get him in the mix. South Carolina blitzes off the corner.
Right there, Elijah Bryant, you just talked about, he was wide open. South Carolina brought a blitz off the edge and left Bryant wide open.
Well, I see coaches coaching him up right now. Antonio Barber just only having 2 or 3 days with these kids, but he's so encouraging when he talks to them. He gives them the opportunity to be a part of the game strategy, which is real impressive. So Coach Pelham, who has been running the 3-4 defense, changed up a little bit second half. And now it looks like he's running the 4-3.
But with that run game, North Carolina and Smith, he had to make a change. Here we go. And right there, he was looking to go to Bryant.
He was, Bryant ran a curl route, and he was open there, too, because everybody slowed down to Smith, and he saw him. However, there's a penalty on the flag, and I believe it's legal use of hands
first
to the head.
Helmet to helmet contact against the defense.
So here we are with the stands here in rainy Greenville, South Carolina, and these parents and fans are out in full force. No umbrella rule here at the stadium, so they're having an opportunity to try to stay dry with this misty, constant rain coming down. But shout out to all our fans who are here supporting us at the Youth Shrine.
And now Klein's checked back in at quarterback. Smith line up in the backfield. There's Bennett.
And Klein throws
Bennett.
Finds
it. Bennett breaks the tackle.
He breaks one tackle. He's down to the 3-yard line. Chris, this is your guy. But Klein comes in, throws the dime.
Great call by Coach Barber. I mean, having the confidence and Klein to go out there and make that play.
Real good call. Jayshon Bennett from Whiteville, North Carolina. Eric Klein from Stedman, North Carolina. Threads the needle.
I look for them to go back to Smith right here now because Zach Klein's team just might be a little shaken up.
We talked earlier about Bennett and what he brings to the table. And when the ball is given to Smith, and he breaks out around the outside. That young man is hard to bring down.
We got a flag right here.
There's the holding penalty.
That'll bring North Carolina's offense back 10.
Mm-hmm.
Klein watches out to give the play to North Carolina.
But South Carolina takes over again with 2 minutes and 54 seconds left, and they are driving. North Carolina, and Klein back at the quarterback position, and he has had the hot hand. Overshoots his intended receiver.
Jennifer Watson right there.
Laramie Watson, running back, linebacker, defensive back. He does a little bit of everything. He's an exciting athlete, too. If he has the opportunity to get his hands on the ball, he could be extremely effective for the North Carolina squad. South Carolina hoping to hold on. 2 minutes and 39 seconds remaining with a 10-point lead. Two-possession game right here. North Carolina desperately wanting to get on the board. Trips out to the left side.
South Carolina looking to bring a blitz right here. They bring it. Here's Bryant.
Klein throws it up, and that ball is picked off. And he's at the 40, and there is no green shirt near him.
Great interception right there.
South Carolina with the pick six.
Number six right there.
I think that was Jacoby Smith.
Great job by Jacoby Smith coming over for the safety position to make that play. I mean, Elijah Bryant had a step on the DB. And Jacoby Smith comes out of nowhere and sets that ball, taking back for six.
Exceptional speed, great hand. He didn't let the inclement weather affect his ability to make the play at all. Good job.
Big play right there for South Carolina's defense. Like North Carolina had a lot of momentum, a lot of big plays, was driving on, looking to score on that drive right there.
South Carolina calls a timeout. It's 2 minutes and 19 seconds, 24-8. Stand up is of South Carolina, 6th grade over 6th grade of North Carolina. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Back right here after that interception by Jacoby Smith. North Carolina will have to force a turnover right here.
South Carolina will attempt.
And it looks like South Carolina is going to attempt the extra point right here. Stone Fleming will be kicking the ball right here for the extra point. He's been practicing all week against our points in practice. He'll have a good chance here to get one through the uprights. We'll have Ezekiel Bell-Boy holding the ball right here. Close.
Excellent attempt by Fleming, and great courage by them on the team. And the rules here, we don't blitz. on, so we don't provide any type of rush on that free kick. So Mr. Fleming attempting the extra point.
I mean, this game's not over yet. North Carolina's going to need a very quick score right here. Put themselves in position to get back in the lead.
So Coach Pelham of South Carolina is the defensive coordinator at Dutch Fort for the last three seasons and ended up in consecutive 5A South Carolina State Championship. Also in 2018, Silver Fox defense allowed 10.1 points a game. And I know you guys had a really successful season. How do you think it's fair against a defense that's only allowing 10 points a game?
Offense is averaging 30-something a game, so I feel like we still have a pretty good chance against anybody.
And the kick is picked up at the 50-yard line.
Onside kick is recovered by the Tar Heels.
North Carolina will take over at the 50.
And that was Eric White from Lumberton, North Carolina.
George Strong with the tackle.
Picked it up, gang of one.
It'll be first and 10 at midfield.
Two minutes and 10 seconds remaining.
Now let's see if North Carolina can get down the field fast. Klein has shown the ability to throw the deep ball.
Tight end to the game to the left. And that is number 19 from South Carolina, Caden Walker from Rock Hill.
All over the place, all game.
Official timeout.
So right here, you got the cheerleaders celebrating. We're so thankful that they came out to cheer and support the team. The North Carolina is coming over to the sideline and rather have an injured player out on the field. And the clock is still running with 45 seconds remaining. This will probably do it. As we take care of our injured player out here on the field. Looks like there still may be one more play. That injured player is Eric Klein. And so that's probably gonna do it for us right here. As both teams came and played valiantly, but there's 27 seconds remaining on the clock. Both teams will come out to midfield and shake hands.
Chris Ellis,
it's been a pleasure opportunity of bringing this game to our fans with you. South Carolina. So right now the series still holds true. South Carolina 24, North Carolina 8. Thank you so very much for tuning in. Stay tuned for more football right here on the Shriners Youth Shrine Game of the Carolinas, brought to you by 10Web TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the U Shrine Bowl, we'd like to congratulate both teams. First, head coach from North Carolina, Mr. Anthony Barber.
Hold on. I'm trying to figure what it is.
And now, we'd like to congratulate our winning team from South Carolina, head coach, Nick Pelham.
I'm going to stop it a little bit. There we go. You got it, Walt?
Again, Career Awards will be given at the end of on our 8th grade game. Congratulations, gentlemen. Job well done. All right, 6th grade teams, please exit the field at this time.